Tom, it was a game, it was a weird game. We were awful and then we were bloody brilliant. So give us a storyline.
3-1-0.
Today was like Christmas at the in-laws.
Oh.
Painful, painful, painful. And then your missus cracks out the whip on Christmas Eve and absolutely comes in with a fucking banger. What a... What a result. What an absolute stunning result.
I don't even know what that means, but okay, yeah.
Stunning result.
Great result. Super Frank.
I thought today we were shocking.
Babe, the football was awful. I was going on 60 Minutes like, what the hell is going on here? But the weird thing is unlike other games,
yeah.
Hello, Lewis. Unlike other games, that result and the second goal especially, yeah. The bundles on me. Like, I haven't had that in ages.
I think that it's amazing how last Saturday we can have a performance of the season against Spurs.
Yeah.
Boxing Day, absolutely shambolic against the Saints, and then come here and play, in my opinion, as bad as we did against Southampton, but just managed to get a win at the end.
That shows courage, though, and bravery. I think we were brilliant.
And it shows something that Chelsea have been lacking for a couple of years now, and that is a real amount of heart and soul. And not wanting to...
Goals!
Yeah, and not wanting to settle for mediocre. I thought Frank Lampard, he was ballsy bringing on... Jorginho in the 35th minute. Like, if it was any other manager, if you can give me any other manager, he's going to make that sort of change in the first half, unless they were forced to.
But it weren't because Emerson was particularly awful. No, he wanted to change system.
Change it up. Yeah. And fine, we didn't really adapt to it straight away, but we got into it. In the second half, they didn't look like scoring at all. We had the majority of the possession. But still, in the middle, I think up until the 85th minute, we were outplayed in every position pretty much. And that central three really just wasn't clicking. And then Chelsea, I don't know how, just managed to get two, excuse my friend, shithouse goals.
Well, what I'll say is that Arsenal's defence is known to be shaky and they let it go. But I thought they defended well for the majority of the game, which is different, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But the difference between us and them is that the win matters and the goals matter at the end. It doesn't matter how badly you play. In these sorts of games, when they're unpredictable, you know this sort of stuff can happen. It doesn't matter how badly you can play, you can get a result out of it, and we did that.
I agree. I think Willian, he was really stifled by David Luiz at times, and actually, fair play to Luiz. I thought up until the goals, he actually had a decent game. He didn't let his head get over him, and actually he played sensibly. But Chelsea, again, all over the pitch, and that is the one thing that I'm going to take out of this game. Look, it's great to be here, and we're taking the absolute piss out of the Arsenal fans. But I think underlying that, there is something not quite right with this Chelsea side at the moment.
We need a few signings.
Absolutely.
But that's
absolutely.
Just, that is obviously, that's obvious, you know what I mean?
Absolutely, and I think the lack of creativity at times is really showing. But again, we're grinding out performances. We're grinding out performances against these big clubs and away. I think we go to Brighton on New Year's Day, we need a performance there, and then we go into a really big run of fixtures. We've got Notts Forest, we've got Burnley, we've got Newcastle. Teams that we are struggling to in terms of like lower than us teams, and we need to be grinding out results because this next month is going to really show if Chelsea are going to comfortably get in that top four or if we're going to be struggling.
Do you think we can get top four, in your opinion?
Frank can do anything.
Love it, Dom.